What's up, YouTube? Franchise Sports TV back again with another video. See, I can't believe I'm actually making this video. I thought some people would at least be smarter enough to know what happened with Michael Jordan coming out of his second retirement to go play for the Washington Wizards. But the Lestan of the choir forced my hand once again. Now, people want to say, you're piling too much on LeBron. No. I'm not. I already told you what was going to happen. Even though I did decide it at one point in time in the last couple of hours, 24, 48 hours. You know what? I'm going to calm down a little bit. But no. Somebody in the comment section, not a subscriber, could have been a hater of the channel, said that Michael Jordan couldn't get to the conference finals with the Washington Wizards, Eastern Conference Finals with the Washington Wizards. All right, let's see here. We already know back then, in the early 2000s, rules were different. Can't do what you can do now. It was tougher. The East was a little bit tougher before it started declining a little bit. Yes, Michael Jordan was 38, 39, 40. Okay. The last time he played was 1998, so he was out of shape. So we're going to compare this with LeBron as well, because LeBron has been consistently playing since 2003. So that's already, argument is already out of there. You're talking about somebody coming out of retirement after 3 years, getting their asses in shape, and they go play 82 games. All right, LeBron this year took two in-season vacations. And is probably out for more than that. I don't even know how many games LeBron played. It's not important. We know he didn't play a full 82 games. Keep in mind, the Washington Wizards were 19-63 the previous year. Therefore, they drafted Kwame Ether Shannon Brown as the first pick in that draft. Let's see who was on that team with Michael Jordan compared to LeBron James. So, Michael Jordan on his team had Courtney Alexander. I remember him, but do you guys remember him? Okay. Kwame Brown. Hubert Davis, which was hurt for most of the season. He's only 33. But now coaching the University of North Carolina. He had him. He had a young Richard Hamilton. Brendan Haywood. Popeye Jones. Christian Laettner. An older Christian Laettner. Tyronn Lue. Coming off the finals appearance with the Lakers. Tyrone Nesby, Bobby Simmons, Ethan Thomas, Jahadi White, Chris Whitney. Now that does not sound like a championship winning team or even a playoff really winning team. But here's the thing that some of you idiots forget about Jordan during that year. Jordan was injured for most of that season. But they still managed to get the 37-45. And Jordan still managed to average 22 points at age 38 and get an all-star coming off from not playing for a couple of years. LeBron last year, we didn't even count LeBron last year. LeBron last year, where were they, like 33-39 last year? Let's look at LeBron's teams for this year and last year. This man played with Carmelo, I think Dwight Howard, Anthony Davis, Westbrook, Rondo at one point in time. You can go to this year, D'Angelo Russell, and a whole bunch of other young dudes, Lonnie Walker, Austin Reeves, all these young dudes. You think LeBron would have a better team? He would get to the playoffs both years, which he did get to this year with a little help from the refs. But last year, he didn't get to the playoffs. People forget that Jordan was hurt and who he played with. Okay, we go to the next year. This is last year in the league for good. 37-45 once again. And who was on his team? Kwame Brown, Juan Dixon, Brendan Haywood, Larry Hughes, Jared Jeffries, who was also hurt, Michael Jordan, Christian Lane, Tyronn Lue, Charles Oakley, Byron Russell, Bobby Simmons, Jerry Stackhouse, Ethan Thomas, and Jahadi White. Ethan Thomas was hurt. They just couldn't do it. Jordan just couldn't do it anymore. But he played, tried to play all 82 games and tried to give it his all. That knee was just too much for him. The knee injury was just way too much. And everybody knew he had a knee injury. It had to be drained out. And Jordan knew when to quit. And he ended the season only playing, the only Wizard that played 82 games, averaging 26-3 in 37 minutes. He was the only 40-year-old in NBA history to score 40 points in a game. This man still had it. This man was able to come out there and play on both sides of the ball. Be able to even, at one point in time, shut the rising star of Kobe Bryant down in the game. LeBron ain't playing both sides of the ball. Jordan didn't ask for a whole bunch of superstar teammates. Jordan didn't ask for all the superstars. I'm trying to think of the current superstars at the time. But he didn't ask for all of them. Unlike LeBron keeps asking for more help every time. So funny. They call this guy, this is the part I'm going to keep calling LeBron the GOAT. They consider him to be the GOAT, but he has done so much less than Jordan with so much more. It does not make any sense to me why people keep saying that. Jordan didn't have the team that LeBron has. He didn't have no Anthony Davis, Westbrook. He didn't have all of that on the Washington Wizards. And gave his all and managed to play 82 games. And know what? At the end of that season, at 40 years old, he said, "That's it. I'm done. Can't do it no more." He had nothing really much to prove anyway at the moment. He just played for the love of the game. I don't know what LeBron's playing for. I don't think it's for the love of the game. But anyways, that's all I had to say.